Hey there. Good to see you.
Man, it's good to see you. Just so the viewers know, Daniel and I don't even know, way back, pictures, and we've talked about the History Museum and all kinds of good stuff. I could talk music with you and the music history of Charlotte for like 4 or 5 hours. In the time we have here, though, you came to me a while back with this really interesting and crazy story and you travel all over the place taking pictures. You found something that really caught your eye, didn't you?
I did. And, you know, you travel the world to find pieces of North Carolina music, and I found one 5 minutes from my house, which is kind of amazing. So one day, my wife and I were out, and we stopped at Fab Fun Furniture near Matthews, and I was looking at the record section, surprise, and there was a guitar case in the back, and I had not noticed it before. Sandra, my wife, said, "Oh, I've seen that before," and I was looking at it going, says the Mellow Tones, it has a couple of names on it, Edna and Daisy May. All right, let me take a picture of this. So I took a picture of it with my phone. I went home that night and posted it to a group of us geeks for North Carolina, professional geeks, mind you, for North Carolina music, the Carolina Rock and Roll Remembered Facebook page. And I posted this photo. And I said, "Hey, I saw this at a store today in Matthews. Does anybody have any information on this or any suggestions?" Well, the posts and the emails started coming almost immediately.
Oh, hang on. Yeah. Now, we're going to tell you what happens next later in the hour. That's a tease right there. Mm-hmm. This is really going to surprise you and blow your mind. But I just got to wait, like, just as a music historian, as a music fan, to find this guitar case and just see it, and it had clearly, and you guys can see that, it had clearly traveled some miles right here. You had to be pretty excited to see some of these details on that thing.
I really was. And all of a sudden you have a name. You have, oh, this is their family. Get in touch with them. This is where they played. Oh, by the way, there might be some recordings of this group that nobody's heard before. It was just this, just tumbled out. It was amazing.
So listen, we're going to tell you the rest of the story later in the hour. Don't go anywhere. This gets like, I'm excited to tell you what happens next right here. Really great stuff. Daniel Costa, we're going to have a link up to his website as well. You can find out more details there. So much stuff at the History Museum as well. Talking music this morning. This is Wilson's World, WCCB Charlotte. We'll be back.
Hey there. Good to see you.
Listen, thanks for sticking around, because we left them with a big cliffhanger earlier in the hour, okay? You were down there in Matthews shopping around, and I go and I look at the records and Sleepy Poet and all these kind of cool places too. You found this guitar case. We were talking about this guitar case. You can see this guitar case right here. So you find this guitar case. There's details and information on there, and you kind of reached out to some friends to kind of maybe go, "Hey, what is this? Whose was this?"
I did. And what we found out was it belonged to Edna Hufstetler. She was in this group called the Mellow Tones with her husband. They played around Rock Hill and Charlotte. The guitar case dates mid to late 60s. Somewhere in the last 30 years, Edna, I should say, passed away in 2007. The guitar case got separated from her family. And Dave of Fab Fun Furniture, the store where I found this, found it in a estate sale many years ago. And he didn't want to sell it because he thought it was something he actually kind of built up his own story around it, what it might be. So he put the guitar case in his store and always marked it not for sale, and really hadn't ever intended to part with it until I showed up and said, "Oh, by the way, this was Edna Hufstetler's guitar case. And if you would like, here's Karen, her daughter." And I got, you know, mentioned, I found another daughter as well. And it actually took about 4 to 6 weeks to coordinate Karen having the time and Dave being in the store to actually get them all together. I actually came running over from another event so I could get this documented as well. There was no way I was missing this.
No, well, that had to be, I mean, after all that time and all that history, and it clearly meant a lot to them. Tell us about that moment where the family was reunited with this piece of their family history.
You can see that Dave and I were talking about music, and Karen just slowly walked. I realized there was a woman standing over here, and she was just staring at the guitar case, and it was her daughter. It was Edna's daughter, and she just hadn't seen it in so long. And there was just this moment of, yeah, that's it. That's the guitar case. And Dave and Karen talked for a while. And obviously I'm there watching this. I'm taking photos and getting video. But it's also like, this is really happening. This is the moment that you can, as a researcher, documentarian, author, photographer, et cetera, you get into documenting these things, but to actually see the moments where people say, wow, I thought I'd never see this again. I thought it was gone for good. It's a big moment. It's a really big moment. Yeah.
Listen, and you're a storyteller, and to be able to kind of have that story, all the pieces come together. You kind of show, hey, this happened on this day in the music history and all that stuff. But this is something where just that connection to the past, and it clearly meant a lot to them. That was pretty awesome. And it wouldn't have happened if you hadn't gone, hey, wait a minute, and all your other friends. So it's kind of cool how all of these different parts all came together that one day.
It really did, and I have to thank all my friends on the Facebook page, including Miriam Lena, who's a very famous collector and musician of garage rock. She emailed me with Edna's obituary. I mean, people, really important people, got invested in this story, and it's wonderful that I can now share this with you and tell everybody, about a really good thing that happened in 2020.
I love that. The year that we will not name. That's the only time we're going to say that year, but it was last year there. Hey, where can people see more of your work and find out more?
Yes, always at danielcostin.com. That is my website/blog. You can go on Instagram as Daniel Costin Photos. And I still have work right now at the Charlotte Museum of History. The exhibit that we did a couple of years ago on the Double Door Inn and other music venues that we've lost. I actually will be taking my the show I did in 2018 at the, sorry, 2019 at the Earl Scruggs Center on North Carolina Music. I'll be taking that to the Surrey County Arts Center opening late next month.
I love it. Hey, listen, Daniel, we'll have a link up to all of that at WCCBCharlotte.com. Thanks for sharing this story with us, my friend.
Thank you. Good to see you again.
Hey, good to see you again. Good stuff right there. This is WCCB Charlotte. Keep on rocking, everybody. We'll be back.